हुजूर, अक्सर हम लोग सत्संग में सुनते हैं आपकी तुके ये होती हैं कि इस जग में न्यारे रहो और रहो हरि ध्यान,
लगे रहो
लगे रहो हरि ध्यान, पृथ्वी में देही बसे
परमेश्वर में प्राण।
हुजूर, रोजाना की जिंदगी में परमेश्वर में ध्यान हर लम्हे में लगाना बहुत मुश्किल है, नामुमकिन लगता है। आप कोई नुस्खा बताएं जिससे हम थोड़े थोड़े स्टेप्स लेके कम से कम उस तरफ मुड़ तो जाएं।
सोच की बात है, ये महात्मा चरणदास की वाणी है कि जग में न्यारे रहो, लगे रहो हरि ध्यान, पृथ्वी पर देही रहे परमेश्वर में प्राण। यानी कि जहाँ भी जन्म लिया है कर्मों के कारण लिया है, कर्मों का हिसाब किताब तो देना ही देना है, उनके साथ जो भी जिम्मेवारियाँ जुटी हुई हैं उनका भी हिसाब किताब देना है, मगर लक्ष्य को नहीं भूलना चाहिए। एथलेटिक्स में जब कोई दौड़ता है उसके सामने उसका लक्ष्य होता है, उस लक्ष्य को लेकर वो दौड़ता है, तो वैसे ही हमें भी कभी अपना लक्ष्य नहीं भूलना चाहिए कि हम किस लिए जिंदगी में आए हैं, मालिक ने क्या लक्ष्य रखा है। अगर वो ध्यान में रहेगा तो आहिस्ता आहिस्ता अपने आप हमारे कदम उसी की तरफ बढ़ेंगे। हम भटक जाते हैं, हमारा ध्यान दूसरी तरफ हो जाता है। तो ये रोजमर्रा जिंदगी में हमने ऐसा वातावरण बनाना है। अगर ऐसा वातावरण बनाएंगे, वो जैसे कहते हैं ना कि द जर्नी ऑफ 1,000 miles स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट स्टेप, तो हमने अपनी तरफ से कदम उठाना है, बाकी मालिक की बख्शिश है।
थैंक यू
बाबा जी। आपने एक क्वेश्चन आंसर्स में कुछ दिन पहले कहा था, जो किस्मत विच लिखिया है वो जरूर मिलेगा, तो जो नहीं लिखिया वो जितनी मर्जी कोशिश कर लो नहीं मिलेगा। अगर ये सच है तो वेयर इज द एफर्ट एंड द फ्री विल?
I think that apart from who am I, this is the next question I think most of us ask, ke how much free will we have. So we have the free will in the sense that we can't choose the circumstances. Circumstances come through your destiny, through your kismet, as per your karmas. But having been put into a certain situation, now it's up to you how to react to that situation. Life is all about making choices. You can as easily make the right choices as you can make the wrong choice. So if you make the right choices, you are finishing the karma. You make the wrong choices, you are setting off another chain reaction. So what is it that separates us? You know, it's animals who react. As human beings, we must have objectivity. We've been given that vivek, that understanding to take the right decision. So from our side, we have to take the right step. Using our vivek, using our discrimination, we must do the right thing. Now, result is not in our hands. If result was in the hands of human beings, there'd be chaos in this creation. Because everybody wants something different. So the result is not in human beings' hands. Effort is in our hands. And if you put in the right effort, and the objective is in front of you and you are working towards the right objective, then with his grace, he will help you to make the right choices and work towards that.
Thank you, Babaji. Babaji, one more. परमात्मा, ये दुनिया बनाने से पहले सब कुछ परमात्मा के पास था, तो परमात्मा ने हमें पैदा क्यों किया, जिंदगी का मकसद क्या है? मतलब सब कुछ सही था तो दुनिया पैदा करके परमात्मा एक तरह से तमाशा देख रहा है।
ये एक पुराना बहुत गाना है, दुनिया बनाने वाले क्या तेरे दिल में,
क्या तेरे मन में
समाई, काहे को दुनिया बनाई। You know, so again, this is something we can only understand when we reach his level. The little child is going to ask the parents a lot of questions. But I guess at that level of maturity, he probably won't understand. So what we do understand is that a certain separation is being felt within us as being separated from the Father. And mind you, I use the word felt, because the separation is not there. We are part and particle. Atam mein Ram, Ram mein Atam. Chinas Gur Vichara. that in the soul is the Lord and the Lord is in the soul, but few have been able to understand it. So we are working towards a certain understanding. We are working towards a certain experience where we can feel that divine essence within us. So it's an experience rather than working towards something. We don't have to go anywhere. We don't have to do anything. We just need to experience it within ourselves. So we are not actually separated. We have created that separation because of the physical. When we see ourselves as distinct physical beings, so we feel there is a certain separation. But the moment you see yourself as the soul, that soul is of the divine essence, then you will never see yourself as separated. We are as separated from the Lord as the ray of light is separated from the sun. We are as separated from the ocean as the small drop of water is separated. So that's more in our mindset. We need just to feel that divine essence within ourselves, and that will sort of take care of this question of separation, the question of wanting to go back or achieving something. We are there. When He gave us human birth, we are there. So He's this life. As somebody said, we come into life thinking that we need to sort of understand what it is to be human. And the moment we learn what it is to be human, the merger will take place automatically.
उसी ने अच्छाई बनाई उसी ने बुराई बनाई और फिर he says सब मेरे पास वापस आ जाओ मतलब you find your way back to me.
No, he hasn't made anything negative. We see things as positive and negative. उसने कोई बुरी चीज नहीं बनाई. Whatever he has created as positive. But having to protect ourselves, we've created certain considerations, certain social laws. So to protect each of ourselves from each other. So we have made things into good and bad. He, for him, everything is this thing. Now, as we say, one man's food can be another man's poison. Everything doesn't suit everybody. What can suit you may not suit the next person. And therefore, social laws were brought into place that we don't encroach on each other's freedom. Because absolute freedom means if I'm free to do anything I want to, then if I don't like you, I should have the freedom to hit you. But then that's encroaching on the other person's freedom. And that is why these social laws were enacted, where we respect each other's freedom and still we are able to maintain our own independence.
Baba ji, sanu apni expectations te kis tarah kabu pana chahida
hai? You see, the problem, all pain and pleasure comes from the expectation. We expect too much from everybody. When are we able to fulfill everybody's expectation from us? When we cannot fulfill their expectation, how do we expect them to fulfill our expectation? Sometimes they will and sometimes they won't. So our mindset should be that if the other person has tried, maybe it's not possible what you are asking. So it is important to keep that balance and not expect so much from everybody, especially from your husbands.
Thank you, Babaji.
Babaji, karni aur daya meher ka bahut gehra sambandh hai. Aisi wo kaun si karni hai ya wo kaun sa tarika hai jo karne se अधिक से अधिक दया मेहर बरस सकती है
उसके हुक्म में रहना उसकी रजा वे वी डोंट डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन गुड एंड बैड वी आर एबल टू एक्सेप्ट द गुड एंड द बैड इन इक्वल मेजर टुडे वी ट्रीट एवरीथिंग के दिस इज गुड फॉर मी और दिस इज बैड फॉर मी व्हेन यू स्टॉप थिंकिंग अबाउट द गुड एंड बैड एंड यू एक्सेप्ट ईच थिंग एज हिज विल यू नो वी ऑफन told that story in satsang where the the ministers tell the king that you favor this one minister more than all of us. And why do you favor him? So the king gets some fruit. He cuts it and gives it to everybody. And everybody who tastes it makes a very sort of bad face because the fruit is very sour. And when it's given to this gentleman, and he eats it without making a face. So he said, what do you think? He said, it's wonderful. And he said, everybody else thinks it's sour. He said, in my life, whatever has been given to me has been given by you. And it was all good. So one little thing, I'm not going to distinguish and say this is bad for me. There must be something good in it for me, even from this fruit. So it's a question of our faith. When we start having that kind of faith that he's only doing the best for us, why would I distinguish what is good and what is bad? What is happening in my life? I would accept it as it comes and see that, okay, if he's given this to me, it must be for my benefit. How do I move on?
कबीर साहब की वाणी है कर्म की गति न्यारी संतों बड़े बड़े नयन दिए मिर्गन को बन बन फिरत भिखारी ये कर्म की गति प्लीज समझा दें बाबा जी
कबीर साहब ने बहुत सरल तरीके से समझाया है कि कर्म जो जो करेगा तो वही फिर भोगना भरना सो कर्म मींस एक्शन अब हर एक एक्शन का एक रिएक्शन होगा व्हिच इज द लॉ ऑफ नेचर कि जो भी आप कदम उठाएंगे जो भी आप करेंगे उसका एक रिएक्शन होगा वो भी लॉ ऑफ केमिस्ट्री है फिजिक्स है सो उसका रिएक्शन तो होगा अब हमारे में वो इतनी ताकत नहीं है कि हम सभी को मान सकें कभी मानते हैं कभी नहीं मानते मगर रिएक्शन तो होगा तो इसलिए हमें सोचना चाहिए कदम उठाने से पहले अगर सोच के कदम उठाएंगे तो अपने ताकत के दायरे में रह के जो भी होगा तो हम सहार सकेंगे मगर अपने दायरे से बाहर निकल कर कोई कदम उठाएंगे तो उसका बोझ शायद इंसान से उठाया नहीं जाएगा
थैंक यू बाबा जी व्हाइल मेडिटेटिंग हाउ कैन वन इंप्रूव वन्स कंसंट्रेशन और फोकस
रेगुलरिटी प्रैक्टिस मेक्स परफेक्ट I mean, whatever you do, you know, regularly and you are practicing every day, that automatically will become easy for you. I remember the first time one got into the car, you had to, you know, really think. And if somebody talked to you, you'd say, listen, don't talk to me, I'm going to bang the car. But over a period of time, months, days, years, now you've gotten that practice. Where you can talk, you can look outside and the hand and the feet automatically move. So practice makes perfect.
Thank you, Babaji.
Babaji, karma is the mover of destiny. Then why do we need to forgive? If we forgive and don't forget, of what purpose is such forgiveness?
The first and foremost is who are we to forgive?
Yes.
You see, as long as you are forgiving, then you brought the eye into it. And if the eye is into it, then the benefit of that and the load of that also has to be borne by the eye. Na? So who am I to forgive? Only he can forgive. And he doesn't judge. So he's a forgiving father. He's willing to forgive, provided we are willing to seek that forgiveness. He's not there to judge us. So we should never think about us having to forgive anybody. Are we perfect? Have we never sort of hurt anybody? And if we make mistakes and in our own manner, we sometimes hurt other people, we need to learn. We need to see how to correct our attitude towards everybody. But to say that anybody has the ability to point a finger at others. You see, as human beings, we have very few choices. But one thing we can choose is the measure by which we will be judged. So, if we are going to point a finger at others, one day the finger will be pointed at us. If we love others, he will love us. We judge others, we will be judged. So we can't afford to point a finger at anybody else. We must inculcate that attitude of wanting to you know, love everybody and move on rather than holding on. We hold on to this negativity and it becomes a burden for us. The other person may think about it or not, but then you are carrying that load of negativity in your mind. So we must learn to move on.
When you make a mistake and you want to rectify it, and you, because you know that you can, you know, not make it again, but again, if it keeps happening, how does one try and get out of this?
But then where is the vivek? Where is the sense of discrimination? At the ending of the day, he's given you a sense of discrimination. I don't believe that people don't know what is good and bad. They choose to ignore it is a different thing. But most of us, as we grow up, we all know what is good and bad. And if I choose to regularly go and make that mistake, then I have to bear the burden of that. But I make a mistake, I'm sorry, I correct myself. Okay. In the house, the child does something wrong and he comes and apologizes to the mother and she'll say, okay, don't do it again. Again he does it, she's going to say, look, don't make a habit out of it. Again he does it, and she's probably going to say, look, if I don't pull your ear, you're not going to learn. You're just taking everything for granted. So he's willing to forgive, provided we learn. But if we are going to take him for granted, we are going to take everything else for granted, you know, we'll see ahead what happens, who knows karma, who knows what is in the afterlife and all that. Aren't we suffering enough in this life that we think that we want to keep the suffering on for more lifetimes? So he's afforded us the opportunity, let's learn. And if we learn, he's a forgiving father.
Babaji, suppose somebody is not on the path and you know, I mean, you know that the person is making a mistake and you try and tell him and the person doesn't understand.
Whether they are on the path or not really doesn't make a difference. It's a very simple thing. Is the Lord a biased Lord? That He's made somebody rich and somebody poor, somebody healthy, somebody without limbs. If He's a biased Lord, then He's not worthy of our attention. If He isn't biased, then how do we account for all this distinction? This is where the karma comes in. You see, so every action of ours, there is going to be a reaction. And we are paying for the consequences of our past actions. And we have to own responsibility of our future actions. We can't just put it on anybody or say, I don't know, or somebody, you know, the person who's part of the crime also gets a punishment. So our duty is not to force our philosophy or our thinking on anybody, but just in a positive manner, you know, in a nice manner, just to explain to them, and then it's their choice.
Thank you.
You can't live anybody's life for them. You can't live your own children's life. Yeah? Your own children don't listen to you. They think that maybe they'll have a different experience. So you can only create a positive environment. You can teach the child, but you can't live his life for him.
Thank you. Babaji, we are constantly reminded that this is not our real home and we shouldn't get attached to things happening around us. Right now, we're seeing so much suffering all around us at the moment. How do we stay detached and yet be helpful to others?
You see, many things are said to us in a manner of speech, and that is to explain to us that everything in this creation is transitory. It is not permanent. Means everything is going to move on. Now, would you get, suppose you've hired a house and you've hired a car, you know that one day that car I have to return and house is rented and I have to leave that house. Logically, you understand that I can't get attached to my surroundings out here because I have to move on. What is it in life that doesn't change? The weather, the people, everything changes. But somehow we don't want things to change. We want them just time to stand still. But time can't stand still. So he has afforded this life to us to learn that these are not permanent things. Relationships will change, weather changes, everything will change. Life is not going to go the way you want it. So whether it is illness, whether it is sadness, happiness, it will come and go. And we have to adjust our mental attitude, knowing that all this is of an impermanent nature. It is not going to be there. This too shall pass.
Babaji, all the people suffering at this point in time, how do karmas play? How do we accept it?
When somebody is down, I think the last thing he wants to hear from you is karma. That, look, it was in your destiny, you have to go through him. At that moment, what he needs is support. He needs sympathy. He needs love. He needs understanding. So don't start moralizing to them, ke, oh, it is karma and all that. Somebody passes away. The main thing we all go and say is, oh, he had to go one day. They know it. It's not that they don't know it. But they have to come to terms with the situation in life. And you have to help them to come to terms. So don't moralize to them. Just try and be supportive to them. Be loving and caring to them, that they get that strength and confidence to move on from that. We all understand the theory of karma, that yes, it's whatever our actions are, we are going to have to account for everything. But there is a time to explain, and there's a time where you just need to be supportive.
Thank you, Babaji.
At different points in time, we've all tried to find love in some way. And that also, because we look for it in the physical form, seems transitory, and that can be very painful sometimes. How do we truly understand the meaning of the very small little word called love, Babaji, especially loving the master?
But, how can you find love? Love is not something which is on the outside that you go searching for it. And, you know, these are all Mills and Boone stories, Barbara Cartland stories, where you saw a knight in shining white armor and he swept the girl off her feet. These are all stories. Love is within you. You have to experience and feel it from within. It's an emotion that is beyond anything else that you can ever experience. And if you have a positive attitude, you will see that love in everything. Maharaj used to say, the Lord loves His creation through us. And similarly, if we see that positivity in everybody, we see the Lord in everybody, it will be just helplessness. Loving the Lord through His creation. We have restricted love to something very physical. Now, if you are going to restrict your love to physical over a period of time is going to change. And does it mean that your love is going to go away? So, if we say we love the person, what do we love him for? We love him for his qualities, him or her for his or her qualities, their personality, what they are, or we are just loving them for their body or for one single aspect. That's the problem. Now, we don't see things in totality. I mean, what does beauty have to do with it? You don't want to put somebody on a mantelpiece and admire them out there. You want, beauty is something which comes from within. And that beauty will never change. The outer manifestations of these things will change. Inner will not. Obviously, so you have to reach that level to be able to feel and experience that love with them.
Babaji, how do we learn to love the master?
You can't. Maharaj used to say, it's like asking a blind man to seek the one with eyes. So, again, he will help you to discover that love from within yourself. That is what the meditative process is, you know, searching yourself, finding that inner love. And once you find that inner love, then you will not distinguish. It will not be based on distinction. Then you love everybody for what they are. Today, we want to change people we love. You know, I want to mold my child in the way I think is right. I want to mold my spouse, or I want to change my spouse into what I think is right and wrong. I'm not appreciating them for their qualities. But if I were to build on their qualities, they would become good human beings. So our entire life is based. When we were in college, you know, who would you like to go around with? Somebody who's a little flirty, outgoing, partying and all that. And then you decide to get married to her. And once you got married to her, the very qualities which attracted you are the qualities you want to change. Because then, as a wife, you feel that, no, now she should not behave like this, she should behave like this. So are we trying to live our lives through the others, or are we trying to be appreciative of their qualities? So if we want others to sort of admire us and look up to us, we must learn to do the same with them.
Babaji, how do we learn to distinguish between love and desire? Because you said everything in the physical stems from desire, but we can also find love?
See, everything stems from desire. Everything stems from desire. Even the desire for the Lord is a desire. Desire for spirituality, that's also a desire. So at our level, there is going to be a desire, no matter what. The desire to be clean, I go and have a bath. Desire to sustain this body, I go and eat food. So everything stems from a desire. But the objective is the desireless action, the nishkam karma. We have to work towards that. Today there's a calculation in whatever we do. But we have to reach that level where we are doing something because it is right, not from what we are going to get out of it or what the calculation is. Then it becomes desireless action. So, of course, the moment you reach that level of desireless action, then life is over. But within this physical realm, everything stems from a desire. In this realm, we need to channelize our desires. We need to use our vivek, our discrimination, to desiring something which is positive, which is beneficial, rather than something which is going to pull us downward.
So, Babaji, the desireless action is in some way love? Does it help us?
See, action means you are doing it. When it comes naturally, it's something, you know, like a mother, for her to love a child is natural. It's not an action she plans or she sort of programs into herself. It stems from within her. And you have to reach that ability.
Babaji, bhajan simran karte vakat, kya aisa hota hai kabhi, kyunki kuch log poochte hain ki hum ji negative raaste par chale gaye, aisa kyun?
Negative raaste pe nahi koi jata, magar hota kya hai, maine kai bari benti ki hai ki zindagi ki kitab ek kori kitab thi. Jo bhi aapne zindagi mein kiya, dekha, paya, wo kitab mein likha gaya. Ab jab bhi aap kitab kholengi, pehle wohi payengi jo likha hai. Ab hum kya karte hain? Simran ka maksad to ye tha ki hum simran kare aur in sab cheezon ko mita de, ki hamari slate phir se khali ho jaye. Magar hum unki parakh karni shuru kar dete hain. Parakh karoge to wo utna zor pakad ke dobara jaake sama jayenge. So agar zindagi mein koi negative cheez hui hai, ab jab aapne kisi cheez ko mitana hai, usko samne layenge tabhi to mitayenge. Mere computer mein koi cheez hai jisko main delete karna chahta hu, main screen ke samne launga tabhi to delete ka button press karunga na. Ab us waqt delete karne ke bajaye main scroll karna shuru kar deta hu, usko dekhna shuru kar deta hu, to kya hoga? Main us taraf chale jaunga na. So bhajan simran ke waqt agar hum apna dhyan aankhon ke piche rakhenge aur simran karte rahenge, to koi aisi negative cheez nahi ho sakti. मगर आपने शुरुआत की और उसके बीच में आपने बागडोर किसी और को पकड़ा दी, तो फिर तो उसकी मर्जी है ना कि किस तरफ खींच के ले जाए. शुरुआत तो मैंने कर ली मन को संभालने की, मगर बीच में मैं तो पीछे हट गया और मन को कहा तू आगे ले चल, तो फिर तो वो तो किसी तरफ भी ले जा सकता है ना. तो हर वक्त हमने उसकी बागडोर अपने हाथ में रखनी है. जब तक हम उस मन और माया के आगे नहीं जाते, उस वक्त तक बागडोर अपने हाथ में रखनी है। और जब अगर हम सिमरन करते रहेंगे, हम कभी भी गलत रास्ते पे नहीं जा सकते।
थैंक यू
हुजूर। मैं बेनती करना चाहूंगा ऑन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ बेनती एंड फॉरगिवनेस या बख्शिश। तुसी समझांदे हो कि असल बेनती तो सिमरन भजन है, वो ठीक है, पर जिस बंदे का विवेक ठीक है, वो कोई गलती कर लेंदा है, उस तो बाद अपने आप नूं सुधार लेंदा है, तौबा कर लेंदा है, मच बैटर। पर आम इंसान को गलतियां हो जाती हैं, वो सच्चे दिलों मालिक अगे बेनती करता है कि मैं बख्श लो। उस अवस्था दे विच मालिक दी बख्शिश की रोल प्ले कर दी।
देखो दिस ये सारी चीज स्टेम करती है कि साड़ी अरदास की है, साड़ी बेनती की है, साड़ा प्रेयर की है। हुन प्रेयर दे डिफरेंट लेवल्स है, इस बेनती दे डिफरेंट लेवल्स है। शुरुआत विच देखो मामा की करती हैं, बच्चे नूं भावें समझ भी ना होवे, असी छोटे सी साड़ी नानी सानू जपजी साहब का पाठ कराती होंगी सी, हालांकि उस अवस्था में तो सानू समझ भी नहीं आती सी कि असी की दोहरा रहे हैं, मगर उहदे नाल इक फिर इहो जिहा असी जुड़ जाते हैं। और जिवें जिवें वड्डे हुंदे हैं फिर मन च इक इच्छा आती है कि ये जिहड़ी चीज़ मैं दोहरा रहा इहदा की मतलब है। सो शुरुआत विच जो भी प्रेयर है वो भावें सोचिए ना सोचिए, ग्रंथा पोथियां नूं पढ़ना है, कोई चीज़ दोहराना है, उहनूं असी मान लैंदे हैं कि ये साडी प्रार्थना है, साडी बेनती है। मगर जिवें जिवें अगे वधदे हैं, साडे अंदर थोड़ी जी जागरता आती है, मन विच एक इच्छा उठती है कि असी समझिए कि असी की बोल रहे हाँ, की अरदास कर रहे हैं। सवाल यह पैदा होंदा है कि मालिक जे देण दी ताकत रखता है तो कि जानण दी ताकत नहीं रखता, उन्हूं की साडी अवस्था का पता नहीं गा। और जे वह दे सकता है तो वह जान भी सकता है, तो ये असी अपने मन की शांति वास्ते करते हैं। साढ़े मन में जो बेचैनी होंदी है, अपने मन नूं शांत करने वास्ते असी हुण जिवें कोई गलत काम हो गया या किसी नूं दुख असी दवाता, हुण मन च हुंदा है कि मैं उस तों जाके माफ़ी मंगा। हालांकि सच्ची माफ़ी तो यह है कि आपां उस चीज़ तों सीख के उन्हूं ना दोहराइए, मगर जुबान दे नाल भी मन नूं शांति मिलती है कि मैं माफ़ी मंग ली, चलो मेरा बोझ हल्का हो गया जी। मगर जे असी उस चीज़ नूं दोबारा दोहराता तो फिर माफ़ी का तो कोई मतलब ना ना होया
जी।
सो जिहड़ी सच्ची अरदास है, सानू लफ्ज़ां विच लियाण दी लोड़ नहीं, बिन बोले सब कुछ जानदा किस आगे की जी अरदास, वो जानदा सारा कुछ। ये अपने मन की शांति वास्ते है, ये नहीं कि उन्हूं नहीं पता
जी,
उन्हूं साडे सारिआं दी अवस्था पता है। अपने गिल्ट वास्ते, अपने मन की शांति वास्ते असी लफ्ज़ां दा इस्तेमाल करते हैं, मगर जो सब तो वड्डी प्रेयर हैगी है, सब तो वड्डी अरदास है, वो जदों असी चुप करके उहदी हाज़री उन्हूं हाज़र नाज़र मन के उहदे हुक्म विच रहण की कोशिश करते हैं, वह सब तो वड्डी बेनती है। ये बाकी जिहड़ियां चीज़ां हैं तुसी कह लो मन नूं शांत करन वास्ते, क्योंकि साडा जिहड़ा दायरा हैगा वह जिसमानी दायरा है, जिन्ना चिर कुछ बोलीए ना कुछ कहीए ना मन नूं शांति नहीं आती
जी।
इस करके ये बाहर असी अरदासां करते हैं
जी,
मगर वह तो जानता है ना
जी।
तो जे असी सच्चे दिलों असी किसी गलती करके मन विच हैगा कि मेरे तो गलती होगी, अगे तो मैं बचाव रखना हैगा,
बख्श देगा बाबा जी
है,
वो गुनाह बख्श देगा।
उहदे कुछ है ही, उहदे कोल है ही प्यार और बख्शिश
जी,
वो तो प्यार दा सागर है ना
जी,
होर उहदे कोल तो है ही नहीं। जे मालिक परख करन लग पिया तो फिर बख्शूगा कौन
जी,
मालिक नहीं परख करता। ये परखा विच साडा अपना मन सानू लैके आता है
जी,
मन चैन दे नाल नहीं जीण। सो तंग साडा मन करदा है, मालिक नहीं करदा
जी।
मालिक तो हर वक्त बख्शन नूं तैयार है। आपां उस द प्रोडिगल सन की कहानी पढ़ी है कि बाप तो इंतजार विच बैठा सी कि वह वापस आवे, वो अपनी गिल्ट विच बैठा सी कि मैं किवें जाऊँगा, किस मूँह दे नाल जाके माफ़ी मंगूंगा। पर जिस दिन वो वापस आया उन्हें तो उस वक्त उन्हें छाती दे नाल ला लिया ना, ਵੱਡੇ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਜੀ ਕਿਹਾ ਕਰਦੇ ਸਨ ਕਿ ਭਾਵੇਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਔਗਣ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਓ, ਗੁਣ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਓ, ਆਓ ਤਾਂ ਸਹੀ। ਸੋ ਅਗਰ ਆਪਾਂ ਉਹਦੀ ਸ਼ਰਨ ਵਿੱਚ ਆਵਾਂਗੇ ਉਹਦੇ ਅੱਗੇ, ਭਾਵੇਂ ਚਲੋ ਲਫਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੀਆਂ ਬੇਨਤੀਆਂ ਕਰ ਲਈਏ, ਲਫਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਅਰਦਾਸਾਂ ਕਰ ਲਈਏ, ਮਗਰ ਉਹ ਤਾਂ ਮਨ ਦੀ ਅਵਸਥਾ ਜਾਣਦਾ ਨਾ ਕਿ ਕਿਹੜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਭਾਵਨਾ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਅਰਦਾਸ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਅਸਲ ਕੀ ਮੰਗ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਔਰ ਅਸਲ ਕੀ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ।
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ।
ਠੀਕ
ਜੀ, ਮਾਈ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਇਜ਼ ਔਨ ਅਵਰਜਨ ਇਨ ਆਰ ਐਵਰੀਡੇ ਲਾਈਫਸ। ਹਾਊ ਡੂ ਵੀ ਅਵੋਇਡ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਐਨੀ ਅਵਰਜਨ ਔਰ ਡਿਸਲਾਈਕ ਟੂਵਰਡਸ ਐਨੀ ਪੀਪਲ ਔਰ ਕੰਟਰੀ ਔਰ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ? ਹਾਊ ਡੂ ਵੀ ਰਾਈਜ਼ ਅਬਾਊਟ?
ਵਾਈ ਸ਼ੁਡ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਅਵਰਜਨ? ਐਵਰੀਬਡੀ has come with his or her destiny, which is based on their karma, and they are going to have a behavioral pattern which may or may not suit us. My having an aversion to somebody or my not liking somebody, that can't change his or her destiny.
Not a person, more people.
Same with people. Whether it is countries or something, every president of the country or every prime minister of a country is going to think about his country, because he's responsible for that. He's not responsible for the other country. So he's going to do what is in the best interest of his country. So we can't put it into aversion that I am averse to this or I don't like this. Good for you. But that doesn't change his destiny. He's going to behave in the way he has to behave.
I just found it a natural tendency
to be averse from people.
Towards people who, not people, persons who are thinking opposite of the way we think.
No. Where is it written that we think right things and everybody else thinks wrong? If I want them to respect my way of thinking, I must respect their way of thinking. Never. This is arrogance. It is absolute arrogance if we think that we are right and the others are wrong. That is what we must have, a healthy respect for each other, for each other's way of thought. You know, now we can say we are vegetarian. Now animals, sometimes they are not vegetarians. So should I say that this animal, I'm averse to this animal? But that's his way of life. That's what he was made. That's how he was made. What can that poor animal do? I agree with you that sometimes, you know, you can meet somebody and without him having said a word, you take an aversion to him. And sometimes you meet somebody, they may not have said a word, but you start liking them. Chemistry. Good chemistry and bad chemistry. But I won't go to the extreme and use the word aversion. If you don't like somebody, avoid them. But to say that I must sort of change that person or I must impose my thoughts on that other person, why? That's arrogance.
We love our culture. We love our country. So persons who are opposed to our country, opposed to our
they
culture.
But they like their country, they like their culture.
Yeah.
So then, they are fulfilling their duty, they are fulfilling their destiny. Just because it clashes with my destiny, doesn't mean that they are wrong. I must learn to respect them.
Thank you.
You see, that's what all the problems in the world are, because we are not respecting each other. We want to change everybody to our suit. And the best part is, you change everybody to suit you, you won't like them. Opposites attract. If everybody thinks like you and everybody behaves like you, I mean, it'll become so boring, man. You won't like them. You will say life has become so monotonous. It is the change, the variation in people. I mean, you have got so many people out here, they are all different from each other. If everybody was the same, you'd have the same question, you'd have the same answers. Everything would be the same. Would you like that?